You'll find workflows in the automation part of the product. This page is divided up into different triggers. Then each trigger is like a heading with related workflows listed underneath. This page can get a bit busy, so a good tip here is to keep everything minimized except for what you're working on. And this shortcut can help you with that. Okay, let's create a new workflow. First, you'll see there are a range of templates to help you get started. For now though, let's hit create from scratch. Now you can choose the trigger you want your workflow to start with. This first row lets you automate what happens at the start of a conversation. The next row is more for things that happen during a conversation, while the last row contains a reusable workflow trigger. We'll cover this in more detail in a later course. For now, let's choose this trigger. The workflow builder is a visual canvas made up of different elements, but the trigger always comes first, because it lets you control the channel your workflow appears on, the audience who sees it, when and how often it triggers, and the overall goal of the workflow. That's the basics of your workflow menu, how triggers work, and what they control.